Hello and welcome to Working with Fractions. In this video, we'll be talking about reducing fractions. Congratulations, you've done the heavy lifting and now know how to solve addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division problems using fractions. But there's still one more step before you get your final answer. You have to put it in its lowest terms, and this is what we call reducing fractions. So the reason we reduce fractions is for the sake of clarity. Say that you have 48/96 as an answer for a problem you've just solved. Well, looking at it right now, it's hard to see what it means. Is it equal to a quarter, a third? After reducing it, however, you can tell that the fraction is equal to 1/2, which you can understand easily at a glance. So, how do we get these fractions down to their lowest terms? In some of our previous videos, we've reduced fractions by dividing the numerator and denominator over and over again by 2. But the proper way to reduce fractions is by pulling out prime numbers. So a prime number is a whole number greater than 1, which can only be divided evenly by 1 in itself. What we do is we try to divide the numerator and the denominator separately by the same prime number, starting with the smallest prime number and working our way upwards until no more prime numbers can come out. Now this may sound a bit confusing, so let's try this method with the fraction 15/90. First, let's go through the prime numbers and see if either 15 or 90 is divisible by them. We start off with 2, which we realize can go into the 90, but not the 15. So we move on to the next prime number, which is 3. And 3 is a factor of both 15 and 90. So we can pull out a 3, which leaves us with 5/30. And then these cancel. Now the denominator, 30, can be divided by 3, but the numerator cannot, so we move on to the next prime, which is 5. Now both 5 and 30 are divided by 5, so we can pull that out, cancel, and that leaves us with 1/6. Now this fraction is in lowest terms, and that's the end of the line. Congratulations, 15/90 has been completely reduced. So if we decided to write everything in one step, we would realize that in the case of 15/90, to factor it completely into primes, we would get 3 times 5 over 3 times 5, so you can cancel these ones, leaving us with 1 over 2 times 3, which is otherwise known as 1/6. And there you go. So for some other quick examples, we can clearly see that the primes 3 and 5 come out of 15/60, leaving us with 1/4 as our reduced answer. And that the prime number 2 comes out of 8/12 2 times, leaving us with 2/3. And there you have it. For simpler fractions, the way that I always think about reducing them is dividing the numerator and the denominator by the same number. This way the fractions themselves aren't actually changed, but you can still fully reduce it. Always remember to reduce your fractions, especially if you're playing some of our fun games on Always Ice Cream and Clever Dragons. Check them out if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.